Well, what can I say about the 25-year-old? I suppose the first thing to start with is, if you're new to whisky, this is going to be a really big challenge for you. If you are a whisky connoisseur and you know what the whisky is about, you're just going to fall in love with this. The reason for this is we would always describe this as a whisky drinker's whisky, because there's a big punch right up front. You have to fight your way through. It's like, best way to describe it, it's like coming to Orkney. A lot of people who are new to Orkney come here and the wind is a lot stronger than they've ever had before, and they get a bit of a fright coming off the plane or coming off the boat, and they go, oh my God, why am I here? And then after about, you know, a couple of hours, they acclimatise, off comes the jacket, off comes the jumper, and then the most beautiful island in the planet is open to them. So it's like that. You have to fight your way through the pain to get your reward at the end. So it is the darkest whisky of everything that we make, basically. It is up to 50% first fill sherry casks, and these are predominantly European oak. If you turn this 45 degrees and spin it all the way around, then what I want you to do is to have a look. The tears and legs in this are very, very small. That's high alcohol. We're now up to 48.1% alcohol. Welcome to the pain of the whiskey. And then the tears and legs take a long, long time to come down the glass. Lots and lots of flavour going on here. If you smell the whiskey, just be warned when you smell it for the first time, because the alcohol content's way up there, it really, really jumps up your nose. And the use of first fill European oak sherry cask really accentuates that. That like sweetness kind of just jumps right up there. We would describe that as vanilla. It's about as sweet as you're going to get, basically. There is a wonderful spicy note to it, but that actually becomes more obvious in the tasting. And if you think like things like white chocolate, it's that kind of overt sweetness. Then we taste it. Cheers. Just chew it and chew it and chew it and chew it and swallow. And what should happen is this: the front of your tongue should literally go on fire. Your lips might begin to tingle. But once you fight your way through that pain, fight the way through that tingling sensation, your mouth will dry, and dry immediately, and it will stay dry for a very, very long time. And then you just get spicy flavour after spicy flavour after spicy flavour. We're looking for things like cinnamon and nutmeg, the kind of big obvious ones. And then it's after a good 40 to 50 seconds, that's when your mouth recovers, and you get that saliva begin to go back into your mouth, and then that gentle smoky aftertaste just begins to come to the front of the mouth. That is a very, very big whisky, but really only for the experienced.